Hello, I'm Edu from Edu4Java, and this is the Android tutorial number 7. We're going to see Android debug breach and SQLite. Okay, let's start. If you remember, I installed the SDK here in the desktop. I hope you install it in a better place. But if you open it, you can find inside a tool directory and inside an adb.exe file. I'm going to use this ms2 command gel. I'm going to put android list avd, that lists the devices that are defined in my emulator. I'm going to start my emulator. I have only one, this dev22. I start with emulator at dev22. Start, you know, is from MS2 to start in another window, in another process. Okay, here I have the emulator loader. I'm going to minimize this for now. And I'm going to use the Android bridge adv shell. This is a Linux command shell inside the phone. You know, the in this case is the emulator. Here in the emulator, I already work with contacts and put two contacts. One with Edward's name and for Java's last name. Phone 555555, email edu4java@gmail.com, and as a company name I put www.edu4java.com. And here there are another Eli for Java, and the phone is 444444. Okay, now this is set up. We can go and try to see what we can do in the Linux shell. This Linux shell, in this moment, we are inside the Android, the phone Android emulator. But if we put a real phone in an USB connection, we can do the same in a real Android phone. Okay, let's do something here. ls. Okay, we make a list as in any Linux, and we see all we have inside the root directory. With ls systembin, we can see the command that we have in this Linux. Remember that is not a complete Linux, it's a version, modifier version. And here in data we can see all the packages that store data. There is one package for each application. And inside this directory, data and the name of the package of the application, we can find the data for each application. If the application contains a database, we can find a database directory inside. We can see with this instruction the databases. Okay, we have all these databases. Contacts 2 is the one that we are interested in. This database has contain the data that I put here in the application contacts, Edu for Java and Eli for Java. Let's try to see if we can get the information. Okay, the database is exactly here. Com Android provider contacts is a data provider. Then we can access to this database using SQL little 3. It's an application that we have in the form. We feed this application with the name of the database. And okay, we are in. Inside the SQLite, we can write here, we can write SQL. Okay, there is a shortcut, this dot tables. It's a shortcut for this select that you can see that now. And then we get a list of all tables we have in the database. Here there is a data table that we can just make a select to see what we can find inside this table. And yes, here is the information that I put in the contacts. Edu for Java. The name is Edu. Edu for Java is the last name. 555555. The number 444444. This is another number from Ellie. Ellie for Java. World Wide Web. Eduforjava.com and Edu for Java. My email. Okay. Let's continue. We can see with this shortcut, stem data, we can see the structure. The way that the SQL little show us the structure is with the create table SQL. You can see here is all the information you need to know the structure. It's an easy way to show us. Okay, with dot exit we quit from SQLite, and with exit we could quit from the Linux shell. Now we are again in MS2. Here we can use this command, Android Device Bridge pull, and put feed this command with two parameters. The first parameter is a directory inside, a file inside the Linux, and the other is a directory outside. This command is useful to get a file from inside the phone to our operating system. We are going to get contact to. I have already one here. I'm going to delete it and run it again. Okay. If everything is okay, after I get enter here, we are going to get here the file. Let's do it. Okay, yes. This is my database. This is the database that I have in the phone. Now it's in my PC. Then we can use a more friendly tool to see what is inside this database. I start to search and there is a lot, but I found one that resulted really beautiful to me because it's a Firefox plugin, Yeah, this is SQLite Manager. You can see here is a plugin. I install it in my Firefox and then I get this here, SQLite Manager. Okay, it's trying to open the database. I say no and I'm going to pick it again. As you can see, then you need to change here because I have a different extension. It's in the place where I left it. Okay, and here you have a friendly view of the database, more than we used before. And if you remember, we checked data table is here, and the same information is here. You can see Edu 555 444 Ellie. There is all this here. Okay, we can see Here, all the tables, we can see all the views here, indexes, and even triggers. Yes, I think it's a really nice tool. Let's see something about the SQLite. Okay, the SQLite, here where we are in the site, the main thing is serverless. Most of the famous databases we work today, for example, Oracle, MySQL, Postgres, all have a server. A server, you can think in a server like a waitress. Anytime we need data, we ask for the waitress or the server to get something for us. And this serverless is different. It's like self-service. You go and just get the data directly. It's an API. It's not another entity. It's just an API that you use to get the data. The data is in a file, and there is no process working with the data. This is good for a phone, because if you have a server, you need to maintain. It's really more complex, and nobody wants a DBA for our phone, no? Anyway, this is better than just a file, because we use SQL, that is a language, a really no language. And we have zero configuration, the zero configuration we talk about. Transactional, yes, we have transaction. Maybe not so powerful that Oracle or MySQL, but we have a seed, atomic, consistent, isolated, and durable. If you are interested in a seed, you can check in a wiki. And is self-contained. This is really interesting. You don't depend on other components. It's really encapsulated. You need an API to access to the operating system. You have to store, at the end you store in a file, but there is a little support for an API to handle thread, but does not depend on any other service. Most widely developed SQL database. Yes, this is easy. It's open source, it's free, and for example, Mozilla Firefox has one inside, then you have 300 Mozilla copies, then you have 300 million database. Mac computer have inside, then you have 20 million. PHP have one. Skype have one, 450 million people. Yeah, it's really used. Okay, this is enough for the Android Device Bridge. We see the Linux operating system, the file system. We see we have an idea about SQLite that we are going to use in the next tutorials. And that's all for this tutorial. See you.